Hello, my dear friends. Friends, I keep getting many comments on almost all my videos, but many people commenting on my videos which I made about the great Tibetan Lama, Lobsang Rampa, and out of them, many people label him as a fake fraud. Yesterday, I got a comment from someone who mentioned that Lobsang Rampa, in one of his books, had written that cats are from outer space. So, this person thinks that Lobsang Rampa was delusional. This is the word he used, delusional, which means someone having faulty judgment. That makes me laugh because I know that not only cats, but all life, including humans, didn't originate on this earth. It was designed and created elsewhere in a far-off universe. And there are infinite number of universes. And in those universes, there are infinite number of worlds which are populated with very advanced beings, and humans are nothing before them. They're so advanced, so intelligent. Well, that is a topic which I can make another video about cats. That's a different story. But here I am concerned why so many people call the great Tibetan Lama, Lobsang Rampa, as fake. Now, I came in contact with Lobsang Rampa's books way back in 1969, and since then I have been studying all his books, and I had wonderful experiences, and my development, my spiritual development is mainly because of his teachings. So I wonder that a person, a divine being, very advanced, spiritually advanced soul, which came here to help humanity and has given wonderful, rare knowledge in his books, which you may not find elsewhere at one place. And some other things are very rare, he has mentioned. All that is truth. But only if you have faith and you make all his books a lifetime study, because his books are not any literary information. They contain rare spiritual concepts which can be understood. If you study those books again and again, and also do some pranayama, breathing exercises, and meditation. Without breathing exercises and meditation, you cannot discipline your mind. Your mind cannot be made subtle to penetrate into the subtle concepts of spirituality and understand those things. Right? So, I wonder why people call him fake. So, I thought deeply about this, and I have come up with the answer that there are two main reasons why people have no faith in him, why people call him a fake. First reason is that many Westerners, they are unable to understand the concept of transmigration. Although, even in the West, Shakespeare never went to college, never had any formal education, but the works which Shakespeare had produced, even today, people spend their whole life studying those literary things which he has written. And they get PhDs by researching on his work. So it was transmigration. A very highly evolved soul which wanted to give all this knowledge came in the body of Shakespeare, whose soul was released with divine permission, and that highly evolved soul lived in Shakespeare's body and produced all those wonderful literary works. The same thing happened in case of Jesus Christ. Well, that is a different matter. I will discuss in some other videos. But the point is, since average Westerner do not grasp the concept of transmigration, that this physical body is just like a car, a vehicle, and the driver is the soul, which can, with divine permission, be released, and another driver or soul can be attached to the same body, only with divine permission in rare cases. So in case of Lobsang Rampa, this is the first reason why people think that he was not a Tibetan, he was a fake. Lobsang Rampa's body had deteriorated a lot because he was earlier tortured by Japanese and Russians, who took him as a spy while he wasn't. So they tortured him. So his body was not livable, but his task was not done yet. He had to write books. So the divine forces which control all life upon earth, they decided to select a person in whose body Lobsang Rampa could live and complete his tasks. So an Englishman by the name of Cyril Hoskin, whose basic frequency matched with that of Lobsang Rampa, was selected. So that person's life was watched from above, and the divine beings found that Cyril Hoskin was somehow not happy with his life. He wanted a release. So they contacted him while he was asleep and asked him if he could willingly vacate his body, and he will be compensated, he will be released, sent to heavens, and in his body a great being, Lobsang Rampa, could live and produce teachings for helping humanity. So Cyril Hoskin agreed to it. So his soul was released from his physical body, and before this happened, Lobsang Rampa had instructions from the divine being to go to Tibet. So he went to Tibet, and there the great lamas kept his body in a vault, in deep cave, preserved it, and his soul was, at the decided moment, his soul was released, and there in England, Cyril Hoskin's soul was released, sent to heavens, and Lobsang Rampa's soul was attached to the physical body of Cyril Hoskin. So after Lobsang Rampa had occupied the physical body of Cyril Hoskin, it is wrong to call that person as Cyril Hoskin. But it is very hard for an average person to grasp. And this is the main reason why people think that he was an Englishman, he never went to Tibet. How come he claims that he was trained in Tibet and he is a Tibetan Lama? And then, in the following 9 years, Lobsang Rampa has mentioned this also in his books, that in the next about 9 years, each molecule of his preserved body in Tibet changed with each molecule of the body of the person he took over, Cyril Hoskin's body. So he regained, Lobsang Rampa regained his original appearance and features. Isn't it wonderful? But only if you have faith, only then you can grasp such subtle things. So this was the main reason why people still think that he was a fake. He was just an Englishman who was born in 1910 in England. They don't realize that this physical body is just like a vehicle, and the real driver is the soul. So when the soul has changed, it is no longer the previous person. It has happened in many cases, in India also. Right? It happened in the case of Jesus Christ also. Right? And the second reason is why people label him as a fake, that Lobsang Rampa was very highly spiritually evolved incarnation. He could go at will to any dimension. There are infinite number of dimensions. He could go to any level of existence in the astral world, in the subtle worlds. And also, you may be knowing that everything which happens, every event, is recorded on the subtle matter called Akasha. So there is an Akashic record of all the memories, whatever happened actually. Right? At any point in time, anywhere. So Lobsang Rampa had divine permission to tap into the Akashic record and get first hand information what exactly happened. Written history is not right, it is wrong mostly. The rulers of time, rulers which govern the world from time to time, they keep altering the history books to suit them. But this Akashic record of memories cannot be manhandled. It contains truth, right? So Lobsang Rampa wrote about cats and all life which originated elsewhere only by witnessing the actual events in the Akashic record. So, my dear friends, especially those who label him as a fake or fraud, Lobsang Rampa doesn't lose anything if you call him fake. He is in a very high dimension right now, again doing lot of good work in the kingdom of God. He is not affected at all what you think about him. But if you label him as a fake or fraud, then you yourself are losing, because you are unable to study his books and benefit. If you study his books contain such information, knowledge, rare knowledge, which can transform you, right? Change your life, make you more successful, even in worldly matters. Your concentration will increase. All my spiritual development is mainly due to following the teachings of Lobsang Rampa and doing some practice also. I had wonderful experiences. You too can have. But only if you have some faith and you study all his books deeply, again and again, and do some pranayama and meditation. Pranayama and meditation, they make your mind disciplined. They discipline your mind and make it subtle to go deep in spiritual matters and understand. I hope this clarifies a lot of doubts about the great sage. Thank you for watching.